Greetings from IADBN, the Indian Association of Dermatologists, Venereologists and Nephrologists. I am Dr. P. Narasimha Rao, the National President of 2019, addressing you. Today I am very happy to share with you that the Telangana State IADBN is coming out with this educational video on superficial skin infections. In this video, number of highly erudite dermatologists are going to address you on the various aspects of superficial fungal infections which has become rife in the society today. At present, there is an epidemic of superficial fungal infection, that is Tinea, otherwise known as dermatophytes, in whole of India. One of the reasons for this is topical steroid misuse, and IADBN is working actively on this on various fora for last 2 to 3 years. I hope in this video you will get a lot of information on how to prevent and take treatment and how to approach a right doctor, that is a dermatologist, for care of your skin problems. So happy viewing. Thank you.
So we'll talk about Tinea and its different types now. Tinea is also called ringworm. It is caused by fungus. The rashes are red in color, severe itching, and they spread like ring-like structures. As the days grow, they become darker in color. Depending on the site involved, we call them with different names. When face is infected, we call it Tinea faciae. When beard is involved, we call it Tinea barbae. And when body, it is Tinea corporis. When groins and buttocks, we call Tinea cruris. When hands are involved, we call Tinea manum, and feet and toes, Tinea pedis. When nails are infected, we call Tinea angulum. And when scalp and hair is involved, we call it Tinea capitis. This Tinea capitis is commonly seen in children. And Tinea incognito. Tinea incognito is Tinea treated with other ointments like steroids or in combination ointments, steroids, antibiotics and antifungal. These combination ointments are available in medical shops. So rural people, usually they approach their local doctor or they directly go to the medical shop and buy these ointments and apply over the Tinea. Initially, they get rid of the redness and itching, and so they continue applying the ointment. When these steroids are applied for longer duration, the skin over there becomes thin and it gets stretched. So my advice to the people is, please consult a qualified skin specialist when you have a skin problems, so that you will be healthy. Thank you.
So what is the main cause of fungal infection? It is the fungus itself. It is Tinea rubrum, Tinea mantegrophytes. But there are other causes which are actually, they are the troublesome causes. They are the ones, because of that, because of those causes, we are not able to control the fungal infection. So what are those other causes? Nowadays, wearing tight jeans or synthetic dresses, the tight dresses by itself will cause a lot of sweating, and this, it can spread the fungal infection. Then next is wearing ill-fitting shoes. That means wearing shoes all the time, morning to evening, also can cause spread of the disease. Next is sharing clothes, sharing towels and sharing bed sheets. All these can spread the disease from you to others and from others to you also. Next is not bathing daily. This is also another important factor. And not washing your clothes. That is another important factor. The other factors, the other causes are, is taking incomplete treatment or incorrect treatment. These are the important causes. That is why we are not able to control the disease.
How do we diagnose Tinea? Usually, diagnosis is clear based on the history and how it looks like. But sometimes, applying creams, especially those containing steroids, the picture is modified and it may be required to confirm the diagnosis by performing certain tests. These include KOH mount, where the skin scrapings, nail clippings and hair samples are taken to visualize the fungus. A dermoscopy or trichoscopy can be done, which helps in magnifying the skin and hair. In unusual presentations, a fungal culture and a skin biopsy may be considered. A lot of skin conditions mimic tinea, which includes the most common ones like psoriasis, eczema, and other allergic rashes. So it is always better to consult a certified dermatologist for the diagnosis.
Hello everyone. I will tell you regarding the creams and lotions used for tinea or ringworms. Creams are used when there are few patches of tinea. They are applied once or twice daily according to the potency of the drug and its efficacy. Newer topical creams are needed to be applied less frequently and for lesser duration of time. They are to be applied 2 cm more than the margin of the tinea, and they have to be applied even 2 weeks after the rash has cleared. When the fungal infections are extensive, systemic medications or tablets are used along with creams. In pregnant women, lactating women, and in children, creams are safer to be used. Resistance to fungal infection comes because of inadvertent use of over-the-counter creams which contain lesser concentration of the medicine than needed, and also the steroids. Continuous, long, prolonged usage of steroid creams causes several side effects. Inadvertent use and unknown use of other creams can cause your fungal infection difficult to treat, and also it spreads resistance among the society. We should consult a dermatologist and take proper treatment for tinea.
Fungal infections of skin usually cured by creams and ointments. We need to prescribe drugs like tablets, capsules when not responding to creams, rapidly spreading infections, extensive infections, palms and soles scalp involvement is there and associated with the diabetes. They act on fungal cell wall, cell membrane synthesis, which result in death of fungus. We have different classes of drugs based on their structure, mechanism of action. Generally, we prescribe chrysophalvin, ketoconazole, fluconazole, cetraconazole, itraconazole, terbinafine, and other drugs in capsules and tablets form. Each drug has its own advantages and disadvantages. We need to use them in correct dose and correct period of time. We usually advise for 2 to 4 weeks. Your dermatologist will decide the type of drug, dosage and duration, which depends upon the type of fungal infection and duration of fungal infection, weight of the patient. Incorrect dose, irregular use can cause treatment failure and side effects. We should avoid these drugs to pregnant women, children, and decrease the dose in liver and kidney patients. So, it is advisable to use these drugs under a dermatologist, that is skin specialist, supervision only.
Today, I will be sharing few important do's for patients with fungal infections. Once diagnosed, patients with fungal infections should take bath twice daily with a gentle soap for a good skin hygiene. After bath, skin should be completely wiped dry with a clean towel. Wear only loose fitting, dry and clean clothes, and change socks and undergarments daily. Wash your clothes in hot water and dry them under the sun. Remember to wear clean footwear in public places, especially gyms which have a mat flooring. Fungal infections take at least 4 to 6 weeks for complete cure. An absence of itching does not mean that the infection has resolved. Make sure to complete the full course of treatment as prescribed. Visit only a certified dermatologist for all your skin diseases, including fungal infections. Regular follow-up till complete cure is achieved is a must. In order to prevent recurrences, make sure that your sugar levels are well under control if you are a diabetic. Pets may need treatment if they are symptomatic, and all affected family members should seek treatment at the earliest.
I'm going to tell you about certain things you should avoid while getting treated for fungal infections. Along with the prescription of a qualified dermatologist, certain precautions from your end helps in treating fungal infections and prevents recurrence too. Do not use over-the-counter creams like Cybal, Itchguard, Ringguard and others. Avoid using steroid creams like Candid B, Clop G, Panderm, Foderm for fungal infections. These steroid-containing creams might give you a temporary relief, but in fact, increases the severity of fungal infection and makes it resistant too. Do not wear tight-fitting clothing like jeggings, leggings, jeans, and tight innerwear until few months after the infection subsides. Do not give clothes for washing to Dobi. Wash your clothes separately. Don't share your towels, clothes, or shaving kits with others. Do not wear threads around neck, waistline, and hands, as these threads retain sweat and makes the fungal infection recurrent. Continue medication for 2 more weeks even after the infection subsides. Do not wear wet clothes or semi-dry clothes. Always dry your skin before wearing clothes. Don't use unwashed socks for daily use. And last but not the least, avoid self-medication for skin problems. Don't apply any ointments for skin concern without the prescription of a dermatologist.
Self-treatment or treatment from unqualified people with wrong medication or low dose medication for inadequate period of time, and most importantly of all in our country especially, use of creams containing corticosteroids has been the main reason. Though these creams seem to give temporary relief of symptoms, they cause increase in spread to self and others, and also cause permanent damage in the skin with stretch marks and thinning. What is a superficial infection can go deeper because of these creams. This makes a necessity of treating with higher doses, longer periods of time, and has increased the burden of cost from hundreds to thousands. So we appeal to you all to make use of this information to help us to help you fight this menace, which is tinea or ringworm. Thank you.